All right, so a couple of weeks ago, we released a video where I talked about my current portfolio within the P2P lending space. I've pointed out that I could exit most of it within 1 month, and one viewer asked me how this is possible and whether I could share some of my strategies here. This is why in this video, we'll be covering the topic of liquidity and why I think it plays an important role when investing in loans. I'm your host, Jakub from P2P Empire, and if you are new here and your goal is to become more educated in the P2P lending space, consider subscribing and hit the notification bell to not miss out on future videos. So when it comes to P2P lending, the risk and return ratio is by far the most important factor to consider. It's fairly easy to determine the return, however, it can be quite difficult to figure out the real risk of an asset, and that's where liquidity comes into the picture. Liquidity basically determines the time you need to withdraw your funds. Now, if you are investing in the stock market, you can liquidate your positions and the stock exchange is open. When it comes to cryptos, you can liquidate anytime as cryptos are traded 24 hours a day. Now, when it comes to P2P lending, you don't always have the ability to liquidate your positions anytime. This doesn't mean, however, that you should completely neglect this aspect of P2P lending. The main goal of liquidity is to make your investments more flexible. Having access to your money will allow you to use it for unexpected expenses or perhaps invest it in other more profitable assets. Now, I think that the most important role of liquidity is to decrease your exposure in loans when there is a chance that certain risks might materialize in the near future. So basically, if you spot any shitty stuff going on, you can exit your positions rather quickly. If you've been following this channel, you might be aware of the most important risks that you should consider in the P2P lending space, mainly the platform risk, lender risk, borrower risk, and the market risk. Let me give you a few examples of how liquidity can help you protect your investments by decreasing those risks. When you are seeing that a platform is imposing certain restrictions or its loan book is deteriorating, you can use the secondary market to exit your position. A relevant example would have been Viventor. Investors who followed our website had plenty of time to exit their portfolios before the platform announced a wind down. You can also use the secondary market to exit your positions when you start noticing that the number of delayed loans for a particular lender is increasing. This has been often the case on Mintos, where the platform ended up suspending the lender from the marketplace and basically completely locked the ability to liquidate your assets. If you're investing on crowdfunding platforms like EstateGuru, you can use the secondary market or the early exit option to withdraw your money in the case where you see that the project has defaulted. Now, one defaulted project amongst many other loans from the same borrower is really not a big deal. But if all of the borrower's loans have defaulted, you can be confident that the recovery of the loan principal will take longer, which increases the risks that you end up losing some money. You can also use the secondary market to exit your positions when certain market conditions change. A perfect example would be the recent suspensions of loans from Vovo, which is a Turkish lending company that is listing loans on Mintos. The marketplace has suspended Vovo loans as the value of the Turkish lira towards the euro is deteriorating. Typically, lending companies do cover the currency exposure risk, but too much inflation can put the lender in trouble. So if you are following related market relevant news, you can predict certain patterns and use the offered liquidity to decrease your risk there. All right, so now we have established a few use cases where liquidity can help you protect your money by minimizing some of the risks. Now let's have a look at how you can practically increase the liquidity of your P2P portfolio. The first step is to invest in short-term assets. Short-term assets are typically unsecured consumer loans. The liquidity is higher as the turnover increases, and you are basically funding loans that are going to be repaid within the next 30 days. If you fear that certain risks might materialize in the future, you can simply stop investing and let the money come back. Obviously, not every short-term loan is the same. As a rule of thumb, you could focus on established lenders from larger lending groups operating in regulated markets. A good tip is also to invest on platforms where the buyback guarantee has not failed in the past. The profitability of the lender or the lending group can also be a good indicator to consider, especially if the lending group offers a group guarantee. Another strategy that will help you with liquidity is to choose platforms with a dedicated secondary market. It's important to mention that every secondary market works in a slightly different way, and sometimes you have to pay a small fee to sell your investments before the end of the loan term. We would recommend selling certain loans on the secondary market from time to time just to get an idea about how long it takes to liquidate your portfolio. The last tip to increase your liquidity is to focus on current assets and minimize investments in delayed loans, as it can hinder your ability to withdraw your funds. At the same time, certain platforms tend to suspend lenders if the amount of delayed loans is increasing. So as you can see, there are certain valuable benefits that come with increased liquidity, which is why it's also one of the rating criteria that we consider when evaluating P2P lending platforms. Now, there are a few disadvantages of this strategy that we should also point out. If you're focusing only on short-term assets, you cannot lock your interest rate for a very long time. Instead, you are exposed to the volatility of the interest rate, which is driven by the demand and supply of loans. In the last few months, we have seen that many marketplaces decrease the offered interest rate as institutional investors are buying bonds in bulk, which decreases the supply of loans on certain P2P lending platforms. If you invest in long-term assets with a fixed interest rate, you can usually predict your annual return. Be aware, however, that long-term assets are also often bullet loans, which means that the loan principal is also repaid at the end of the loan term. This is important because the risk of this specific asset doesn't decrease over time, as is the case with amortization loans that are being repaid on a monthly basis. The second disadvantage of short-term loans is that they are riskier by default. Investing in emerging markets with a lack of regulation or economical instability is definitely not risk-free. Those types of loans are typically unsecured, which means that you are heavily relying on the ability of the lending company to recover the debt. Okay, so the main takeaway of this video is that liquidity is certainly something that you should consider when optimizing your portfolio. It's a great tool that will help you to mitigate certain risks according to your risk tolerance. Keep in mind that you alone are responsible for your financial choices, and having that additional flexibility to react in certain situations is a great benefit that should be used if necessary. As with any video on this channel, this is no investment advice. P2P lending is risky and there are many risks that might materialize. Always do your own research, don't expose yourself to unnecessary risks, and keep track of your portfolio performance on a regular basis. Alright, so if you have learned something from this video, do me a favor and hit the like button. Thanks for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.